Hey, good morning everyone. So today we will be talking about cognizant interview questions, and this were shared by one of our subscriber friend. So this video will be definitely helpful for all those people who are looking out for interview questions that are being asked for a Java developer in cognizant, and especially for the people who are above like 2 years or 2 to 3 years experience range. So before getting into the question, let us see the mail. So CTS interview questions. Hi, I have attended CTS interview. This is for 3 years of experience and salary offered is 12 lakhs per annum. Note, please hide my email ID. Please find below questions asked in the interview. So this is for, as you can see, this is for 3 years of experience guy. And let us dive into the questions now. So before getting into the questions part, let us talk about two problems that a lot of our subscriber friends face. One, how to get interview calls as a fresher, and two, stuck with small companies. And coming to the freshers, see, jobs are very hard to come by because of COVID currently. And secondly, many times candidates miss out a job opportunity because they don't have a better degree or had a poor network. So these are the two reasons that freshers are not getting jobs these days. And second one, stuck with small companies. So here we found a solution for these two problems, and that solution is one platform called Relevel. Let's quickly visit that platform and see what it is offering for us. So this is the platform, guys, Relevel. So Relevel is India's first hiring torment platform. It is really helpful for freshers and early stage career individuals, as it has more than 500 plus positions plus 50 plus companies already associated with it currently, and believe me, this number is going to shoot up very soon. Here, even as a fresher and even being from a very small college, you can get a package up to 15 plus lakhs per annum. It just completely pure, your based on your pure talent and skills, which will be considered here. And if you can scroll down and see, you can have the list of company names that are already associated with this platform. So you can see Razorpay, Urban Company, Upgrad, WebEngage, and lot of things, 5paisa, and lot many other companies are there. So how to apply? So here you can see there are three popular tournaments, that is business development, front-end development, back-end development. So according to your will, according to your choice, you can register in any one of the tournament, and you can apply our coupon code which is there in the description to get 10% extra discount here. And very important thing here is the registration closes on 22nd June 2021 and the tournament begins on 26th June 2021. And few important things that I would like to share here. The tournament is not related to, like, restricted to BE, BTech or MBA. Anyone can register and participate in the tournament. And the investment, that is 1799 after coupon is applied, will be the best investment of your life. There are three tournaments as you can see, and in each tournament there will be two rounds. One will be prelims and other is mains. And upon clearing the mains, you will be getting a mentoring session. This is very important that you will be getting a mentoring sessions from the Relevel team to help you with clearing the company interviews. So what are you waiting for? Register, participate in the tournament and get the offer. So coming to the first question, that is, what are the different types of result sets in JDBC? So if I remember correctly, there are three types, or like forward only, scroll sensitive, and scroll insensitive, I believe. So this was very long back that I have worked on JDBC result sets. So this was the first question. Coming to the second question, what is row set in JDBC? So how to answer, like, row set is an object that it encapsulates the set of rows, if I'm not wrong, to put it in an easy way. So row set encapsulates the object that is written. And coming to the next one, what is executor framework? So executor framework is like what we can say, provide factory methods like we can say executors provide factory methods which are used to create thread pools of worker threads. To use the executor framework, we need to create one such thread pool and submit the tasks to it for execution. So that is about thread pool. Then what is meant by thread pooling? So like in Java, thread pool represents a group of worker threads that are waiting for the job and reuse many times. In case of thread pool, a group of fixed size threads are created. Like after completion of the job, a thread is contained in the thread pool again. Like it goes back into the waiting stage again. So basically a bunch of threads will be created and will be used as required. It's known as thread pooling, you can say that. What is thread join? So basically join is a synchronization method that blocks the calling thread until the thread whose join method is called has completed. So we will be having t1 dot join, main dot join, like thread dot join mainly. That is how we use that. What is thread local? So in Java, thread local class provides thread local variables. It enables you to create variables that can only be read and write by the same thread. If two threads are executing the same code and that code has a reference to a thread local variable, then the two threads can't see the local variables of each other. So that was about thread local. Next question is, what is the purpose of connection pooling and why do we use connection pooling? So basically to improve the performance, we go for connection pooling. So how to call four REST services at the same time, whereas response time of four services should be max. Four response time. Okay, max, we can do like we can make a service synchronized so that only one it can serve only one request there. So we can do that and make other three services in the wait state. How to generate custom ID using Hibernate? This is a typical process, easy only. So how to capture cookie details from browser and send to backend using Ajax call? Not sure, I never worked on Ajax calls, so don't know the answer. What is functional interface? So basically the interface which is having only one abstract method and having a thread functional interface annotation, so that is known as functional interface. So there were many before Java 8 as well. There were callable, runnable, and in Java 8 there are many that got introduced newly. Why and when do we use functional interface with real-time example in project? So this depends on your requirement completely, so you have to say about your project. What is the default method in functional interface? What is the default method in functional interface? Not sure in which scenario this was asked. When do we use default method? So usage comes into picture, if you want to have if you want to add a few methods that few classes only needs, but not all the classes that are implementing that interface needs, then we go for default methods. Difference between concurrent hash map and synchronized map. So basically concurrent hash map will be it will be blocking only the segments on which the action is happening, like update or adding or removing. And synchronous hash map will block entire map. How does hash map behave if hash code is overridden but not equals and vice versa? Yeah, this is one technical tricky question that you will be expecting in all your interview questions. You prepare well for that. Difference between application server and web server. Coming to the next question, how to disable Tomcat from Spring Boot application and how to add another server? So this is easy, we can exclude the dependency and we can have directly we can add the dependency through prompt, we can do that. What is JaxRS and Jersey and when and why should we use them? These are implementation of REST. How to control multiple requests coming from clients and how to control access to a shared resource in Java? Answer is same for. Not sure about the context here again, so if you know you can comment it out in the comment section. And one request is, please do like this video, because that will definitely motivate others to share their videos, share their interview experiences, so that we can share it with you. This is the mail continuation. These are the questions that were shared to us. What is executive framework? What is meant by thread pooling? What is thread join? What is thread local? What is the purpose of collection pooling? And when do we use connection pooling? How to call four REST services at the time with the maximum response time? How to generate custom ID using Hibernate? How to capture cookie details from browser and send to back using AJAX calls? What is functional interface? Why and when do we use functional interface? What is default method in functional interface? When do we use default method? Difference between concurrent HashMap and synchronized map. How does HashMap behaves in if hash code and is overridden but not the equals and vice versa? Difference between application server and web server. How to disable Tomcat. So we have covered all the questions. I'm sharing the questions on the same day of interview. I think I will not get select as I have not answered properly. Also, interviewer himself told this questions is not for 3 years experience, but he wants me to answer these questions. Okay, fine. So that was about the interview questions that were asked at Cognizant. So which contains about most of the questions are from threads, multi-threading concepts were asked, concurrency on collection. There were questions on collections. There were on REST. There were questions on Spring Boot. There were questions on HashMap, HashCode. Yeah, pretty good questions I could say. So that's it in this video. So if you are on our channel for the first time, please do subscribe us. Don't forget to subscribe. There are a lot of interview experiences and questions that are being shared. Share in the queue. Like the video. If you like the content, share it to other technical platforms so that it might help others. Provide the feedback as well. So if you want to share your interview experiences, you can reach out to the email ID that is given in the description. And if you are supposed like who are we and what we do, so we are basically a bunch of software engineers who attend interviews and share our real-time interview experiences through these videos. You can visit our channel and you can find more than 100 such videos that we have already shared, and it will be really helpful for you in tracking and preparing for interviews, different company interviews. So if you want to contribute us, you can use the Amazon affiliation link that is there in the description on your next purchase at Amazon. And that's it for now. Thank you. Have a nice day.